like and subscribe right now, or this spider will crawl on your face while you're sleeping. Everyone is familiar with the Amazon rainforest. Odds are most of us have done a school project on it in the past, or possibly you're doing one right now. It's one of the most distinctive places on the planet, as well as one of the most beautiful. But while we all know the basics of the Amazon, it is such an expansive ecosystem that it holds some incredible secrets within its depths, from things that are simply astonishingly beautiful to things that could change the world. The Amazon rainforest is an immense ecosystem, providing a habitat for creatures as weird and wonderful as the jaguar, the poison dart frog, and the Jesus lizard. But it's home to more than just the animals that prowl, swing, and slither through the trees. In the depths of the Amazon River, the largest river in the world, live creatures so amazing yet so terrifying that they make jaws look like a nice, relaxing swim in the ocean. Well, ready or not, here are 10 monsters from the Amazon River. Before we move on, I've got a little challenge for you that will take just 5 seconds to complete. So here's the deal. You just leave a like on this video, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell and you'll get 25 years of amazing luck. Try it. It really works.
Shit! Get back!
Number 10. Black Caiman. A black caiman is basically an alligator on steroids. They can grow up to 6 meters long with bigger, heavier skulls than Nile crocodiles and are the apex predator of the Amazonian waters. That means they are basically the kings of the river. They eat nearly anything they can get their teeth into, including piranhas, monkeys, perch, deer, and anaconda. Some more facts? Well, they are the largest member of the alligator family and the largest predator in the whole Amazon River basin. Better watch out the next time you're planning to go to the Amazon for some adventure. Oh, and yes, they totally attack humans. In 2010, a biologist named Desi Nishimura was attacked by a caiman while cleaning a fish on her houseboat, and while she managed to fight it off, it took one of her legs with it. This particular caiman had been living under her houseboat for 8 months, evidently waiting for a chance to strike. Number 9. Green Anaconda. Continuing with the theme of gigantic reptiles, the largest snake in the world makes its home in the Amazon, the anaconda. While reticulated pythons are actually longer, green anaconda are far heavier. The females, generally larger than the males, can reach up to 250 kilograms or 550 pounds, grow to 9 meters or over 29 feet long and reach a foot in diameter. They are not venomous, but instead use their immense muscular power to constrict and suffocate their prey, which includes capybara, deer, caiman, and even jaguars. Preferring shallow waters that allow them to stealthily sneak up on their prey, they tend to live in offshoots of the Amazon rather than in the river itself. The anaconda has been given a bad reputation over the years for being a man-eater as a result of movies and media. Even in Amazonian folklore, the giant anaconda snake is called an encantado, a shape-shifting mythical creature known for kidnapping humans they fall in love with. While there have been claims and fake photos of anacondas eating humans, it is unverified and most definitely not true. There was some stir recently over Discovery Channel's special called Eaten Alive, where a naturalist wearing a snake-proof suit was supposed to be eaten by a green anaconda. The anaconda wasn't interested in eating the naturalist at all. In fact, it was frightened and tried to escape. The anaconda only attacked him after much provocation. Many people turned to social media to express their outrage of this irresponsible stunt, criticizing the Discovery Channel for airing something so completely out of a scientific nature that they would cause harm to an animal. That being said, while an encounter with an anaconda snake could be dangerous, it is highly improbable that the anaconda would try to hunt or eat you. Number 8. Arapaima. Arapaima, also known as pirarucu or paich, are gigantic carnivore fish that live in the Amazon and surrounding lakes. Encased in armored scales, they think nothing of living in piranha-infested waters, and they are pretty effective predators themselves, feeding on fish and the occasional bird. Arapaima tend to stay close to the surface, because they need to breathe surface air in addition to taking in oxygen through their gills, and make a distinctive coughing sound when they emerge for air. They can reach 2.7 meters in length and weigh up to 90 kilograms, which makes it quite possibly the largest freshwater fish. These fish are so vicious that even their tongue has teeth. Arapaima have broad, bony heads, upturned mouths, and streamlined bodies with a dorsal fin stretching along their back towards their tail, which are massive yet stumpy in appearance. The head of an arapaima is a copperish green in color. Their bodies are black with a white center and their tails are red. Number 7. giant otter. Heading up the exactly what it says in the tin category are the giant otters, who, as their name suggests, are very large otters. They are the longest examples of the weasel family, with adult males reaching up to 2 meters or 6 feet from head to tail. Their diet primarily consists of fish and crabs, which they hunt in family groups of 3 to 8 members, and they can eat up to 4 kilograms of seafood per day. Don't be fooled by their cute looks, though. They are more than a match for other of the animals on this list, with groups of them having been spotted, killing, and eating an anaconda. They hold their own against caiman as well. One family has been seen devouring a 1.5-meter caiman, which took them about 45 minutes. While their numbers are dwindling, mainly due to human intervention, they are among the most capable predators in the Amazon rainforest, hence their local name of river wolves. Number 6. Candiru. The Amazon doesn't only breed giants, and the small creatures are just as terrifying, at least if you believe the stories that surround them. Candiru are small, parasitic freshwater catfish famous for launching themselves up the urethra of anyone foolish enough to urinate in the river, and getting lodged in the urinary tract because of the spines that run along their backs. While documented cases are rare, and there is some debate of whether or not these types of injuries occur at all, there is at least one documented case of a man requiring surgery to remove a candiru from his urethra, which also attempted to burrow through to his testicles. However, the candiru usually preys on fish, attaching themselves to larger fish's gills with their spines and feeding on their host's blood. Number 5. Bull sharks. While technically ocean-dwelling saltwater animals, bull sharks are quite at home in fresh waters too. They have been found as far down the Amazon as Iquitos in Peru, almost 4,000 kilometers from the sea. They have special kidneys that can sense the change of salinity in the surrounding water and adapt accordingly. And you do not want to meet one of these in the river. It is common for them to reach 3.3 meters in length, and there have been reports of sharks weighing 312 kilograms. Like many sharks, they have several rows of sharp, triangular teeth and immensely powerful jaws, with a bite force of 589 kilograms. They're also quite partial to a bit of human, being one of the most frequent attackers of people, along with tiger sharks and great whites. Combined with their habit of living near densely populated areas, this has led many experts to label them the most dangerous sharks in the world. Number 4. Electric eels. Electric eels are actually more closely related to catfish than eels, but you probably wouldn't want to get close enough to one to find out. They can grow up to 2.5 meters long and can produce jolts of electricity from specialized cells called electrocytes arranged down their flanks. These charges can reach up to 600 volts, 5 times the charge of an American outlet, and enough to knock a horse off its feet. While one shock is enough to kill a healthy adult human, multiple shocks can cause heart or respiratory failure, and it's common for people to be stunned and drowned after an eel attack. Many of the disappearances recorded in the region have been attributed to eels that have stunned their victims and left them to drown in the river. Luckily for our species, the eels, while carnivorous, tend to stick to eating fish, amphibians, birds, and small mammals. They locate their prey by sending out small 10-volt shocks from their electrocyte cells before stunning or killing them with larger shocks.
This particular piranha vanished 2 million years ago.
Number 3. Red-bellied piranhas. The quintessential terror of the Amazon River, so widely feared that they have inspired a number of questionable Hollywood movies, red-bellied piranhas are actually primarily scavengers. That's not to say they won't attack healthy creatures. After all, given that they can grow to be over 30 centimeters long and swim around in large groups, they tend to be more than a match for most animals. Like all piranhas, red bellies have incredibly sharp teeth, one row on each of their powerful upper and lower jaws. These teeth are interlocking, which makes them perfect for tearing and rending the flesh of their prey. Their fearsome reputation mainly comes from sights of their feeding frenzies, where groups of piranhas will congregate around their unlucky prey and strip it to the bone within minutes. These attacks are rare and can usually be a result of starvation or provocation. Number 2. Vampire fish. Anything with the name vampire fish should automatically be recognized as scary, even after Twilight, and Pierre are no exception. They are absolutely ferocious predators, capable of devouring fish up to half their own body size. Given that they can grow up to 1.2 meters long, this is no mean feat. The large part of their diet is made up of piranhas, which should give you an idea of just how tough these fanged fiends can be. They get their names from the 2 tusks that sprout from their lower jaw, which can grow up to 15 centimeters long, and which they use to literally impale their prey after viciously lunging at them. Their fangs are so big, in fact, that they have special holes in their upper jaws to avoid impaling themselves. Number 1. Paku. One animal certain to be far more terrifying to men than to women, the pacu is a much larger relative of the piranha, known for its distinctive, human-like teeth. Unlike most of the creatures on this list, the pacu are actually omnivorous, and a good part of their diet is comprised of fruits and nuts. Unfortunately for pacu, nuts may not only mean things that drop from trees. Yes, that's right, pacu are allegedly to have occasionally bitten off the testicles of male swimmers. With reports of men in Papua New Guinea being killed by pacu after the fish apparently mistook the genitalia for an easy snack. And don't worry if you can't make it to the Amazon to see these manhood masticating monsters, because they're already spreading into Europe. The main reasons for the spread into other parts of the world is either due to aquarium releases or unwanted overgrown pets. While in the US, this fish was introduced into the wild in some areas like California, Hawaii, Florida, and Texas. However, researchers quickly realized that this fish was an invasive species, which means that they reproduce and spread very quickly and can easily become a threat to the native wildlife.